had some really nice looking gavels at the farmer's market.
Were they all?
The farmer's market. That guy that made the scheme, did you see any gavels?
Oh, yeah, you tried to pick it up.
It wasn't big enough. I need a longer handle.
Bigger.
We'll go ahead and open this regular meeting of Kingsville City Commission to order. It's Monday, March 9th, 2015, 6 o'clock. We have three members present, which makes a quorum. Commissioner Peña and Commissioner Pecos and Commissioner Garcia are on work at the National.
In Washington, D.C.
Yes, so they're doing city business as we speak, I'm sure.
I ran to Commissioner Garcia's wife at lunch, and she said they got to meet President today.
Good deal. We generally open our meetings with a prayer and pledges of allegiance. If you care to join us, please stand.
Yes. Father, we ask that you be here with us tonight and always. Help guide us to do things that are in the best interest of the city, the state, and the nation. Amen.
Amen.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible.
Next order of business is to approve the minutes of the February 23rd meeting.
Make a motion we approve.
Second.
Okay, there's a motion by Commissioner Peña to approve the minutes of the prior meeting, seconded by Commissioner Lippert. Y'all can take turns tonight. Roll call vote.
Commissioner Lippert?
Yes.
Commissioner Peña?
Yes.
Mayor Peña?
Yes. We have several public hearings. They're all dealing with condemnation. The first public hearing we're going to start at 6:04. It's a public hearing regarding condemnation proceedings for structures located at 1247 East King, Kingsville, Texas. And Tom, I think it's kind of to you.
1247 East King. It has been without water since November of 2012. As you can see in the top page of your packet, it has the usual comment codes concerning this item. Also, to add in page 7, I believe, there's a written statement saying that on July 31st, a 90-day extension was given to the property owner until October 31st of 2014. And it's my understanding to this date, no permit has been pulled or any work has been done on the structure.
Okay. This is a public hearing. If anybody wants to speak about this particular item on the agenda, all you have to do is come to the podium, tell us who you are and where you live, and you have 5 minutes, and only 5 minutes, to talk about this subject by law. Okay. Then I'm going to go ahead and close this public hearing at 6:06. We'll go to the next hearing regarding condemnation proceedings for structures located at 409. Yeah, you might as well just stay up here.
Yeah.
409 East Netty here in Kingsville. It's 6:06. We're going to open this hearing. Go ahead.
Again, 409 East Netty has been without water since January of 2010. And again, front page of your packet, it has the typical comment codes that are descriptive of this kind of property. it's my understanding that there has been no extensions given on this.
The balance of these properties look like they're pretty much abandoned.
Correct.
Their owners are from out of state.
Right, not all. I think there's one owner that is lives in the community of the remaining properties, but.
I have a question, Mayor.
Sure.
I noticed that they're way behind on their taxes also from 2007. This is the 409 East Nettie. Okay. And they're still behind on the taxes?
To my knowledge, I can double check that.
That's fine, that's probably, okay, thank you.
Okay, again, this is a public hearing. Anybody wants to speak about this particular subject, the property at 409 East Nettie, all you have to do is come to the podium, tell us who you are, where you live, and you have 5 minutes to talk about this particular subject. I will remind citizens that this might be your only opportunity to speak, so if you want to talk about it, you might want to come up. Okay. I'm going to close this hearing at 6:08. And we'll go to the next public hearing regarding condemnation proceedings for structures located at 508 South 2nd Street.
This has been without water since August of 2004. The typical common codes again, and there have been no extensions for this property.
How long, when was the last time the taxes were paid on it?
One when they're altered. I'll have to look. I don't know off the top of my head, to be honest with you.
Okay. This is the property on 2nd Street?
Yes.
Okay, this is a public hearing. If anybody wants to speak about this particular subject, the property at 508 South 2nd Street, all you have to do is come to the podium, tell us who you are and where you live, and you have 5 minutes to talk about this subject.
My name is Betty Wilson Carter. I live at 829 South 24th. I've been here quite a few years. I lived at 508 South 2nd. It used to be a house there. The house was demolished and they messed up the plumbing that's in that barber shop that still at the present that you're saying needs to be demolished. But that is one thing that's left there for so-called the Black District, Industrial District. If you go down there, you won't find very much left of the Black community. So we need to start somewhere and we're going to start right there. Trying to save that because that's part of the Black history of this town. And I don't want to go over my minutes and things, but taxes should be up to code as far as being paid on that property. Yes, it should be. Okay? And the man that owned this property was Charles Andrews. He worked a lot in this community with Otis West, Dr. Reisner, and several other men. Tyrod Allen was one in particular that recognized these desegregation of all that was going on here in Kingsville in a peaceful manner. A lot of you are sitting here enjoying the benefits of black and white together. But it was a time and period in history that I came through where we were not allowed to go into any establishment that considered white. Some of us wasn't able to bleach our hair and not use our native language in order to pass. But back to the corner. I am definitely going to stand before you trying to get this building restored so it doesn't need to be demolished. Is there any question you want to ask?
Are we allowed to ask questions? Or can we do it? We can do that in the...
You can do it during the action item.
We'll do it during the action item.
Okay.
Thank you.
Sure.
Anyone else?
My name is Dios Carter, and I've lived here, say, all my life. I knew about the Andrews building, because my mother used to live in the house, and she called a lady there, and it was the Andrews grandmother. I purchased the property to restore it, and I came the amount of money I had, I tried to do the best way I could to get an engineer to do the drawing. I got a drawing drawn up, I gave it to the engineer here in Keensville, upstairs, he quits. The garage has been repaired, I had issue with the last inspector I had here named Abel. I repaired the garage, so, not as much, but I repaired the roof. I couldn't do the rest of the building because I came to the water and asked if I could adopt a truck. It was an issue, they said, well, you don't have water on that issue, that property right there, you couldn't get a truck at all. So I said, you know what, I'm gonna get the property across the street. So I ended up purchasing the property across the street, the cleaners. I worked on that cleaners every day, I got out of work, I put a fence up, I moved stuff over there that I had in my own backyard, so I went in trouble with the Beautify of Keensville Commission. And I went to the issue of making sure the building had no leaks or nothing before I purchased the property, and I told the city there was no leaks in the building. The wiring was done by the man, the owner. I talked to some people in the city, and they said, well, still can't get electricity turned on. My goal was to get electricity turned on so I could do more work and then be able to have light to go across the street. So if I had to work at nighttime, I had to cross the street. My goal is trying to get Keensville beautified on the west side. We do have rent properties. I'm not going to say we don't. So I put rent stuff in it now. That's where it's stored in there right now. But I was told I couldn't do that. I had to have a business there. I had to be a C2 business there to get electricity turned on. So I'm getting run around. So it's making me upset that I want to tell people not to come to Keensville. Because I lived here 40 years and I haven't seen no improvement on the west side. Yeah, the roads used to be done by Mr. Horn. Wow, the roads. The park is done because more people went to that park because it was better looking than the other parks. That's all we have on the west side. There's a couple other buildings that I grew up with when I was younger. And it still ain't got repaired because it takes money, it takes time. I'm the only one doing it. My family don't want to get involved too much because this is the headache they want to go through. They want to sue the city. I'm trying to work with the city. Can't work with somebody that don't want to work with you. Thank you.
Thank you. Leotis, did you give us your address?
I'm sorry, the address is 629 West Warren.
Okay, thanks. Okay, anyone else? All right, I'm going to close this meeting because it's 6:14. We'll go to the next public hearing. This is a hearing regarding condemnation proceedings for a structure located at 525 West Lot.
This property has been without water since October of 2006. Again, all the common codes that are equivalent or with this property are there. My understanding, no extensions have been given to this property.
Mayor?
Yes.
I'm looking at the taxes on this one. It says the taxes due by April 2015 was $9,515. So this one's also got the taxes that are due. It looks like it goes back to 2008.
Okay. All right, this is a public hearing. Anybody that wants to speak about this particular piece of property on this subject, all you have to do is come to the podium, tell us who you are and where you live, and you can have 5 minutes to talk about this particular piece of property. Okay, well then at 5:16, I'm going to close this public hearing. We're going to move to the next hearing regarding condemnation proceedings for structures located at 128 West Avenue A here in Keensville.
Property's been without water since July of 2007. And again,
I don't think you need to say anything else after that.
That pretty much tells the story. And the pictures also, Tom.
Sure. I just don't know how much information you want.
I understand. I mean, it pretty much tells tells the story on all these properties. Have you had any extensions or anybody contacted?
No, I have not, or maybe before we've been.
And they're also years behind in taxes.
Okay.
I think from 2005, 8,000 plus.
Okay. This is public hearing. Anybody who wants to speak about this particular piece of property, all you have to do is come to the podium, tell us who you are and where you live. You have 5 minutes to talk about this particular subject, or this particular piece of property at 128 West Avenue A. Okay, then we're going to close this hearing at 6:17. We'll go to the next hearing. We'll open it up at 6:17. It's a public hearing regarding condemnation proceedings for structures located at 1029 North 9th here in Kingsville.
Same thing, Mayor. Been without water, November 2008.
You haven't any contact with anybody?
No, no contact.
When was the last time taxes were paid on this property?
They owe for 2014. It shows here up only to about $213 that they've been paying the taxes prior.
You haven't heard from anyone at all, huh? This is a public hearing. Anybody who wants to speak about this particular piece of property, all you have to do is come up to the podium, tell us who you are, where you live, and you have 5 minutes to talk about this subject. Okay. I'm going to close this hearing at 6:18, and we'll go right into reports from the commission and staff. Courtney, do you have anything?
Yes, sir, a few items. First of all, I want to say we had some heavier rains due today, and due to that, they did have to close the landfill to citizens because the roads out there can get pretty slippery. They also were closing the park at 5 today due to the flooding in the fields. Susan Ivey has worked with the Texas A&M AgriLife Extension Office and Keep Kingsville Beautiful in the City for a spring break activity next Tuesday, March the 17th at Dick Claybrook Park. And they will, from 4 to 6, they'll have some activities and games and crafts. And then at 7:30 next Tuesday, the 17th, they'll be showing the movie Big Hero 6 for anyone that wants to bring their family out. Big Hero 6. Oscar for Best Animated Movie. Also, I was going to mention that there are some school districts that are having spring break this week, and so I just want to remind the citizens to be driving extra carefully the next 2 weeks, as there are children out in some districts this week and children out in other districts next week. The warrant roundup continues this week with active enforcement, so we advise people if they have any pending matters or think they might have any pending matters with the municipal court, they might want to contact the municipal court clerk's office and get that resolved before Officer Davis pays them a visit. We attended the county commissioner's court meeting this morning and participated in a presentation on behalf of the EDC. We wanted to thank all of the participants and also thank the county for coming up with their share of funding for this fiscal year for the EDC. And last but not least, our next regular meeting is 2 weeks from today on March the 23rd. And so agenda items for that meeting are due this Friday by 5, as are staff reports.
Any questions? Anybody have anything on the commission?
I have one quick thing. I sent a letter to the editor, but I want to thank the community for supporting our first farmers market. It was a big success, and I think we're going to continue having a successful one with our vendors and just the community. People were showing up by 8:30, and we didn't even open until 9:00. And a lot of people were still showing up at 12:30 and still buying at 1:00. We have a lot of happy vendors, and I think it's going to get better and better. And now it's on the city. Cynthia, sorry, but now they want an arts and crafts bazaar for a few times a year, because we've got a lot of creative people out there who want to sell their wares. So I want to thank the community for supporting the farmer's market. That's all, Mayor.
I met with Mr. Garcia earlier. I was present at the Kennedy County Commissioner's Court this morning, and they basically asked me if we could, you know, reinstate some cooperation in terms of animal control up in Kennedy County. And I've asked them to look at some of the fees, the fee schedule, and get together with Courtney and see if that's doable. Of course, it needs to be approved by this commission and Clayburg County as well. So just since it happened this morning.
Well, Courtney informed me that Commissioner Garcia and Commissioner Beckles both.
When I spoke with Ms. Alvarez, she didn't indicate, but I would presume that they were together. That Commissioner Garcia met with President Obama and Senator McCain at the NLC conference today. Pictures to come, I'm sure.
I'm sure we're still in good standing with the federal government. Look forward to them being home. I think chamber banquet's Thursday, and I think they're going to be home for that. So.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Good deal. Anything else? If not, we'll go into our consent agenda.
Make a motion to approve.
Second.
Okay, motion made by Commissioner Pena to approve it.
Do you want to have public comments?
Well, why not? Well, let's go do this, and we'll come back. There's been a motion by Commissioner Pena to approve the consent agenda as presented, seconded by Commissioner Lubert. Roll call vote.
Commissioner Pena?
Yes.
Commissioner Lubert?
Yes.
Mayor Pugh?
Yes. Now we're going to go to public comments. This is an opportunity for anybody that wants to come up here and speak about anything they want to talk about. It would be a good exercise for some college kid to come up here and tell us who they are and where they live and complain about potholes or anything else they want to talk about.
One or two out there.
Yeah.
I hate to think I love to speak, but the weather changes my voice, so bear with it. I was speaking to the young lady outside about some things that are happening in Kingsville. And like I said, living here all my life and watching things, if we don't watch it, we're going to kill our own city by not trying to progress what everybody, not by sections, but everybody is a Kingsvillian in Kingsville if you live here. So think about it when you say, I'm not going to take care of that side, I'm not going to take care of this side, I'm not going to take care of this side. But every area needs improvement. And the next thing is, like I was telling her, these potholes are murdering your cars and your trucks. And we can keep putting flowers out and everything, but we need to take care of the surface that we travel on a little bit better than what we have, because we pay a man or a machine to dump rocks after we put some tar, but as soon as it rains more than 2 hours, it washes it up and you become a little pool of water, and your trucks and your tires from your cars hits those holes and you think nothing of it, but it vibrates underneath your car and it can damage your oil pans, your springs, your struts, everything. Constantly going down the same road and that happening to you. So think about taking care of the whole city and not just sections.
Anybody else? Okay, with that, we'll go into our regular agenda. First item is consider condemnation of structure located at 1247 East King. Commissioner, you have something?
Yes, I've spoken to the owner, Ms. Margarita Andres, and she's present today. She provided me a letter that I've shown both of you, where she states that she's sought some help to help her with her roof, and she says she intends to buy the materials, and that's the condition of this particular group that's willing to help her reconstruct her roof. She's also paid up all her delinquent taxes, according to the letter. So she's, all her properties are paid up, and is looking for additional time to secure the individuals and material to take care of this particular roof. So that's pretty much.
How much time does she need?
We didn't talk about that. Ms. Ambiz, you know how much time, do you think?
Maybe 6 months. Just because I'm just going to start paying on that loan that I took off for the delinquent taxes that I just paid. I mean.
Would you come up to the podium, ma'am? I know you don't want to. I know it's a, you just, it, well, what's the condition of the house itself? It looks like, other than the roof on the outside, it's not too
well, it's
terrible.
It's not good siding. Aluminum siding on the outside.
What's the inside like? Has there been a lot of water damage because of the roof?
I believe just the front, the living room, because the rest of the house is okay inside.
Okay, well, this is my dorm, I guess. That's a major thoroughfare. People that come to Kingsville, visit Kingsville, they come down King Street. So it's important that those houses are maintained.
Well, I can't afford a...
I understand that, but I'm talking about putting a roof on it, and you will have to maintain it to a certain standard. I mean, it's you understand what I'm saying? I don't mind giving you some more time to help you, but
well, Delma Rios, she just got a friend that said he would do the job as long as I just buy the material, and he will roof the house.
You got to go through a permitting process with the city on that, so be sure to do so. And when we extend property, I'll be honest with you, I don't know how many hundreds of condemnations we've done through the years. Quite frankly, every time we give someone an extension, it doesn't work. So you need to understand, this just because we give you an extension today doesn't mean that it won't come back up, is what I'm trying to tell you.
So, okay, last year I got an extension, but I was pending the taxes of 3 years behind. So, and I'm up to date right now. They have been paid. I'm just going to start paying the loan.
Okay.
Can I
ask
Mayor and Courtney, you can answer maybe. Before we make any action on this one, I don't know if we can, but can we have Mrs. Embrace? Meet with maybe Daniel and Tom and go through the house and get a realistic timeline on what it's going to take and see if it's realistic for both you and the city. But you'll have to meet with them. You're going to have to meet with them on their schedule. Tom, would that?
Fine, that's what you want to do.
Okay. And then we can maybe get a better idea.
Well, why don't we just go ahead to the next item? We'll just pass this today, tonight.
Just throw this out there.
And then we'll revisit it. Okay. That means we're going to give you some more time. I just want you to know that because we give you more time doesn't mean we won't come back to this. I promise you we will if you don't get the repairs made. That's what I'm trying to tell you. I think sometimes people leave here thinking that we give them extra time and we'll forget about it. We won't forget about it, okay?
I know you won't. Okay. It's in the file.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, ma'am. We'll go to the next item. Consider condemnation of structure located at 409 East Nettie, Kingsville, Texas. You going to read it?
Mayor, I make a motion finding the not able to repair the building or structure is unsafe and present condition is a violation of ordinances and cannot be corrected without substantial reconstruction, then declare the building or structure to be a public nuisance and order its demolition by owner, agent, person in charge within 30 days, or the city shall abate in any manner it deems necessary and proper.
Second.
Okay, motion made by Commissioner Luber to condemn this property, seconded by Commissioner Pena. Any other discussion? Roll call vote.
Commissioner Pena?
Yes.
Commissioner Luber?
Yes.
Mayor Pike?
Yes. Next item is consider condemnation of structure located at 508 South 2nd Street here in Kingsville, Texas. I think this was the Carter's property. I had a couple of questions. The others, can you come back up? And I have down here is the owner is 8 sisters and 2 brothers.
Yes, that's the issue. I'm sorry.
You say that you're the...
Yes, I'm the one that purchased the property, and I put it in there as a business name. And I was told I had to put it back in my name. And the process is going to that. Because okay, they wouldn't turn water on, won't give electricity.
Well, I can understand why they're not turning the water on. Have you seen these pictures?
No, I'm not water there, but that's the other thing. I have another press property across the street. I had the same issue. I put 8 brother and 2 sister across the street. They wouldn't do anything, even though there was no structural problem, no electrical problem. They wouldn't do it because it was not in my personal name.
Have you seen these pictures?
On that property, yes, sir. It is the roof. It's not the structure. It's the roof. Once the roof is taken off, it'd be like the building that your office is in. It will. Rick?
Well, that's when I looked at this. I thought about my office, and you know, really and truly, what happens is, you know, you take the roof off, then you get into windstorm, you know, whether or not the walls are going to be strong enough.
It's old school, and old school is better than what we have now. What happens is, once I tear the building down, the cost, everybody thinks the cost is cheaper. It's not. Okay. It'd just be laying there. It'd be worse the way it is looking now.
I don't know about that, but you know, there's another thing that your mom said, and I take issue with. I don't think there's any commission that City of Kingsville ever had that's more concerned about historic preservation. We were very, very, very active in the Douglas School. And that's on the west side.
Look how long it took.
But we got it done.
Yes, yeah, so it's in 1990.
And we're in the process of helping restore the old high school. Mm-hmm. We're also actively involved in the Flato School property. So I take issue with us not being concerned about, when I say about historic sites. And I knew Mr. Andrews. He was a great man. Did a lot of good things for this community. And I'm just wondering what he would think if he saw his building in the shape that it's in.
Commissioners and Mayor, a lot of cities I go to, when they take over the tax sales, they take the property from the person that I'm paying the taxes through the county, and their entities, they usually board up the house or board up the buildings up. That wasn't done. It's never done in the city of Kingsville. Y'all have partial ownership property before y'all resell it again to a new owner. I'm a new owner. I'm stuck with all. Whatever the new comes around, I'm stuck to do and try to fix.
You think that it's the obligation of the city to board up all the buildings in Kingsville?
Well, you're the entity that owned the property for a long period of time. That house was that way. The house was fine until people started breaking in the house. It should have been boarded up. Like Corpus Christi, they boarded their properties up.
The Claybrook County trustees own some property in the area, and the trustees represent all of the taxing entities, not just the city.
Yeah, not city, water, all y'all.
What's the plan?
My plan is to restore it and try to make a barbershop school if I could. I was starting, I had plans right here, and I gave to, like I said, I gave to them to look at the building structure.
Who's they?
Well, I gave to last year, the engineer was upstairs, and he ain't here no more.
How long you been here, Charlie?
2 years.
Who'd you give it to?
I asked the Indian person who was here.
Okay. Well, that's been
yes,
a little bit longer than that.
I have a question.
Go ahead.
You don't mind?
Sure.
Okay, Mr. Parker, how long would you need to get a new roof on this thing? Because it's not just the roof.
Yes, I understand that.
But I see the roof is going to be the main thing, to clean up the building and get a new roof.
I have got half of it already cleaned out already. Take the sheetrock off the wall. I've done all that. I'm gonna have the other half. I didn't get to do it. I ended up having bees in there in the other half. But that's see. I'm looking this summer to take the whole roof off. That's what my goal is. My goal was this summer to be at City Hall, be on people's nerves, seeing my face all the time. That's my goal.
Okay, summer is...
That's 3 months ago. That's 3 months.
So within what period of time would you be able to get a new roof?
I can just keep coming back to you and show you progress, as I can tell you.
We gotta have a timeline.
Give me 6 months to show that a progress has been made to do the thing. I cannot say it's gonna be done. Everybody wants it like this. What downtown, in City Hall's trying to get that building, it's not gonna be done like this. So why? How are you gonna expect me to do it that way? I don't understand. You're using tax money. I'm using my money. I don't have money. I don't have credit anymore to do anything except what I get by going to work.
Have you had the building engineer to see if
that was keeping? I was showing him engineer work at the time. Now I'm gonna try again a metal roof.
Well, let me tell you something. Before you spend a dime on this building, hire yourself an engineer to see if it's even worth keeping.
What happened?
Because I think what you're gonna find, Leo, is they're gonna tell you that the structure is unsound.
No, they said it was fine. This is what
Who's
they want.
They?
The engineer.
Who's the engineer?
The engineer in Kings. When I talked to him.
What's his name?
The one over here on next to the Methodist Church. I talked to him before.
You have a report?
No, I didn't pay for it. I talked to him personally, but they want me to do this, tear it down. But once I tear it down, that's all everybody wants to do, tear it down. That's the answer for everybody's problem. Tear it down. Well, if I don't like your car, well, don't you sell your car? That don't make no sense. Because somebody don't like something don't mean it can't be done. That's the problem in the city of Keeneland. Everybody wants to tear things down. Yeah, it's not the answer. If I can fix it, let me fix it. But the problem is... That's the roof, and that's the trash. He didn't go to the other side. He took a picture through the door because the bees were at the door. I guarantee you, he didn't go look at that. Other side's cleaned off, perfect clean, no problems. That's the roof.
Let me tell you something. I don't want to tear down anything, Kingsville. I want citizens to keep. I want citizens to take care of their property. I want them to maintain it.
That's what I said.
But is this? And you've had this property for at least 2 years because you came up to see Naeem.
Yes.
Is this taking care of property?
Just
answer the question.
No, sir. I didn't have time. I didn't.
You've had 2 years.
Well, let me explain to you. For 2 years, I've been my time of working and paying taxes and everything for the city of Kingsville. I have done a lot more. You didn't check the other side. The other side, he didn't see that. That side's cleared out.
You could have gotten a trailer.
I've done the garage
during our cleanups that we do every 6 months.
No, sir. That was another problem I was having. That's what I'm trying to tell you. I came to the city trying to get the trailers to clean that stuff and throw it in. But my trailer collapsed on the wheels. I mean, you go to the city lady, you want to walk, my face has been there, asking for trouble. My face was there, talking about that I need a contract to turn water on and different things. I have been there before. And they tell me, you cannot do it. And I haven't been there once they got to put in your name. Probably had to be you. Why? Doesn't make any sense. Why? That's not a city law. That's something personally at the office.
Well, you're busy criticizing city staff, and I take exception to that, too.
That's
not getting you very far with me. And I'm going to tell you something. I do care about this city.
Yes, I do.
And I don't think you do.
Oh, yes, I do.
To leave it like it is.
Look at the property across the street. I was there every day. You didn't go across the street. I've done that property. Every day I got to work at 5 o'clock, I'm over there for speaking to that building. Anybody passed by, that's all been changed. Every single day. I went the same thing to that property, sir.
Mayor, if I might.
Hold on just a second. I want the citizens out there who happen to watch this, I want them to see this property.
And what I'm talking about.
Yes, sir. I understand. Tell the citizens to go to 501 South 2nd Street where the cleaner's at. You see, has there been a change there? Has a big change there? I want to do the same thing to that property until I got them getting turned around in circles.
Well,
and nobody said they want to help me, so you got to go get an engineer, you got to do this. I went trying all those things, sir.
I'll tell you something, man. I think this commission is going to give you some more time. I don't think you deserve it, but they're going to give you some more time. But you need to come up with a plan on how you're going to do it and a timeline, you know, whatever you do. But
I want to come back here and prove you wrong. That's what I want to do.
I hope you do.
A lot of people sit behind desks and think people can't do things. They do a lot of things, they get a little bit of help. Just a little bit of help. They're saying, no, you can't do it.
I love to be wrong.
May I interrupt?
Sure.
One, please. In all fairness, since we did this with Mrs. Ambrose, I'm going to propose that we do the same thing with you. You have to meet with Charlie. Mr. Carden is here, who is our city engineer and our public works director. You have to meet with Tom and Daniel, but you need to do this, I would suggest, within a week or two, and start making a plan. And then they'll come back to us and give us a heads up on what's going on. Because this is in fairness. We want, the mayor is right, we want to save all the buildings we can. However, would you want to live next door to that? Would you want to live, if you saw all of these, we might be upsetting one or two property owners. But the 10 or 20 that live around it, they're happy. And we want to see this. We all grew up with this property. This is near and dear to everybody that's around our age in this room. But you've got to meet with these guys, and you've got to do it soon. And we don't need to be talking about all these things. Let's get some action.
Yes, ma'am.
That's going to be my suggestion, Mayor.
Go ahead.
Just one question. Because there's a difference between Ms. Humby's situation and this one. I want to make sure it's clear. Are the taxes paid up on this property? All the taxes are paid up?
I can't swear all of them. Right now, I'm putting money, my paycheck is going toward taxes. That's all my paycheck. I don't have anything for them. So taxes are paying on a lot more property besides that property. And I can't swear to you.
I don't see that here in this package. I saw it in Ms. Humby's package.
Okay.
But not in this one.
It might be this year's taxes. I don't know what it is. But the problem is, I have.
Well, the taxes were going back to, delinquent taxes were going back to 2002.
No, I didn't have the property then.
That's on the 500 block, but if you do look on the page that's 508 South 2nd Street, according to the statement from the tax assessor collector's office dated January the 16th of 2015, 2012, 2013, and 2014 taxes were due as of January the 16th this year. It could have been paid since January the 16th, but as of the printout date, 3 years were due.
There's still some debt.
Yes, sir.
This is 500 block, which shows all the red, and this is 508.
What do you guys want to do?
I'd like to, I've already made my proposal. So.
What is it? That's what you're proposing.
It is to do the same thing we do with Mrs. Avery's. Give you a little bit of time, but you absolutely have to meet with these guys and get them.
No problem. Guys. All right, well, I guess we're gonna go ahead and pass this also. But before we do, you can sit down, Desmond.
Yes, sir.
I will say this, that there's been some comments about city staff, both existing now and in the past, and I will say this, we got a great staff. They do their job, they work hard at what they do. They try to serve the citizens, and I take exceptions with the comments made about Naeem Khan and the existing city engineer and the planner and everybody else that's involved in this process, Daniel Ramirez and everybody else. They work really hard to try to get these properties where they are, and they work with people. And I just hate it when citizens come up here and misrepresent the fine work that the staff does here at the City of Kingsville. With that, we'll go to the next item. Consider condemnation of structures located at 525 West Lawton here in Kingsville.
Mayor, I make a motion finding not able to repair a building or structure is unsafe in present condition as a violation of ordinances and cannot be corrected without substantial reconstruction. Then declare the building or structure to be a public nuisance and order its demolition by owner, agent, person in charge within 30 days, and the city shall abate in any manner it deems necessary and proper.
Second.
Okay, motion made to condemn this property made by Commissioner Lubert, seconded by Commissioner Payne. Any other discussion? Roll call vote.
Commissioner Payne?
Yes.
Commissioner Lubert?
Yes.
Mayor Fugate?
Yes. Next item is consider condemnation of structure located at 128 West Avenue A here in Kingsville, Texas.
Mayor, make a motion finding not able to repair building or structure is unsafe. In present condition is a violation of ordinances and cannot be corrected without substantial reconstruction. Then declare the building or structure to be a public nuisance and order its demolition by owner, agent, person in charge within 30 days. The city shall abate in any manner it deems necessary and proper.
Second.
Motion made by Commissioner Lubert to condemn this property, seconded by Commissioner Pena. Any discussion? Roll call vote.
Commissioner Luber?
Yes.
Commissioner Fanyan?
Yes.
Mayor Hugan?
Yes. Next item is consider condemnation of structure located at 1029 North 9th Street here in Kingsville, Texas.
Mayor, I make a motion not able to repair building structure or structures unsafe and present conditions in violation of ordinances and cannot be corrected without substantial reconstruction. Then declare the building or structure to be a public nuisance and order its demolition by owner, agent, person in charge. Within 30 days, the city shall abate in any manner it deems necessary and proper.
Second.
Motion made by Commissioner Luber to condemn this property, seconded by Mr. Pena. Any other discussion? I never thought I'd see Commissioner Pena miss Commissioner Garcia so many
times.
Roll call vote.
Commissioner Pena?
Yes.
Commissioner Luber?
Yes.
Mayor Hugan?
Yes. Okay. Bill, the next item, consider a resolution of the City of Kingsville to urge the 84th Texas Legislature to provide $8.1 million in state debt service that will allow Texas A&M University Kingsville to leverage $93 million in issued bonds for the renovation and expansion of the existing facilities and meet enrollment demands in science, technology, engineering, mathematics, music, and other educational programs. And I make okay, go ahead. Your second?
Second.
Motion made by Commissioner Luber to approve this resolution, seconded by Commissioner Pena. I think this is something that the county has already done and the university has asked us to do. And from what I can understand from Dr. Talent, this is looking very promising. So hopefully this will come to fruition. With that, is there any other discussion? Roll call vote.
Commissioner Luber?
Yes.
Commissioner Fanyan?
Yes.
Mayor Hugan?
Yes. Next item, consider a resolution of the City of Kingsville approving changes to the entry-level requirements for the fire department as recommended by the City of Kingsville Civil Service Commission.
Mayor, Commissioners, before you, you have a memorandum requesting some changes to the entry-level fighters. We had a meeting with the Civil Service Commission. Chief Reed made a presentation. We're having some difficulty filling, getting applicants to come in for testing. Chief Reed did make a presentation. He also, there's also the memo that he presented to the Civil Service Commission attached to the packet. And what the Civil Service Commission did approve to move forward with this. And the changes that are being requested is to allow individuals or candidates that are paramedic certified to give them 6 months in which a time period of 6 months in which they need to complete their fire structure certification. If they don't meet that, then we would ask that the individuals or the candidates already be firefighter certified and then complete their paramedic certification within 6 months. And then if we still cannot get qualified candidates, then we're looking to get candidates that are already paramedic certified, and then the City of Kingsville will actually put them through the academy and they will have 9 months in which to complete their fire service. Chief Reed's here if there's any questions.
Anybody have any questions?
I have one. Chief Reed, you're pretty sure we can get some action on this?
We're trying.
Give a shot.
We asked you a while back to, in the Civil Service Commission to only have certified firefighters and paramedics, but we're having problems. We're competing with multiple other outlying fire departments throughout the state to get candidates that are already certified. So
now this is one of those areas where we're gonna have to rely on you guys, and if you think this is okay.
Well, this compromise that we've gone to here is what other outlying small departments are trying to do.
Okay. All right. Make a motion to approve.
Second.
A motion made by Commissioner Luber to approve this resolution, seconded by Commissioner Pena. Roll call vote.
Commissioner Pena?
Yes.
Commissioner Luber?
Yes.
Mayor Pena?
Yes. Next item is consider waiver of a water tap and connection fee for Weavers of Love, which is a new soup kitchen here in Kingsville. Third motion on this. Start it out. It takes a lot.
All right. Second motion to approve.
motion made by Commissioner. Unless you really want to.
It's a good thing. It's a good thing.
Unless you really want to get up here and say something profound.
No, sir.
The other day, Mayor Kamat said, we don't want Sister Elizabeth in here.
No.
She'll have to stay.
Yeah, she'll have you all left on.
Okay, there's a motion to approve this waiver by Commissioner Pena, seconded by Commissioner Lubert. Roll call vote.
Commissioner Lubert?
Yes.
Commissioner Pena?
Yes.
Mayor Pugh?
Yes. Next item is consider introduction of an ordinance amended Chapter 9, General Regulations, Article 8, Parks and Recreation, Section 9.8.41, providing for revision of fees for school teams at L.E. Ramey Golf Course. Look, it's the golf pro.
Yeah, the golf.
Okay, in the rough. Mayor and Commission, we've been approached by several of the coaches from the schools asking for a waiver for the students and the team members to come out and play a little bit of golf. If we offer them 2 rounds per week per student, say Monday through Thursday, at the most we'd be looking at about a $5,000 season expense to the city if all of them played, because we're looking at 38 team members from the students in here locally.
I have a question. When you say season, is that semester or school year or?
Usually during the golf season.
Which is?
Well, they have a spring season. Sometimes they have a fall season if they do it, but most of the time it's just the spring season. But if we, you know, on the green fees, they would pay $475 if they were to be charged. It really doesn't cost us anything except maintenance of the grounds. Now the buckets for the range, they asked for a waiver on that as well, but that's something that directly affects staff where we have to go pick up those balls. So I wouldn't recommend that, but the green fees, if y'all would entertain that, it would help promote golf for the youth, possibly get them to play on the weekends when it, you know, during the summertime or what have you, possibly improve concessions and driving range concessions as well.
Do you have something you want to say?
I know I talked to Bill about this issue because I got approached by a couple of coaches. Mm-hmm. And I know that one of the statements that came from one of them was that some of these services are free in other golf courses. And have we talked to anyone else? I mean, have we, do we know exactly what other communities do for their students?
I know the city of Alice at the country club and the municipal course lets their team members over there play for free anytime. And the university, there's only a team from the university girls. They're allowed to go over there and play at either one of those 2 golf courses for free, no charge.
It's kind of a no-brainer for us, and I think, when I first started playing out there, they had a real big youth program, and I think Chuck Anders was the coach and did a really good job, and a lot of kids went through that program, and you know, golf's something you play the rest, well, you can attempt to play all your life, it just seems like to me when you're promote the youth. And I know this is not an action item tonight, it's an introduction item, but I'm inclined to let them play free during the week. Is that what you're promoting?
Monday through Thursday is generally a slower time of the thing. Okay. And you know, when the coaches bring these team members out there, generally they come out in the afternoon, they'll generally play 3 or 4 holes. And they bus them back to the schools.
And could we extend that to the university also? Since
okay.
Any other? This is an introduction item. This will come back up, I suspect, in the next meeting. So, if anybody's got any questions, then contact the city manager. Anybody else have any other questions? Okay. Thanks, Bill. Next item is consider awarding bids for the vehicle exhaust removal system for the fire department to the vendor providing the best value to the city as per staff recommendation.
Mayor, commissioners, always a pleasure.
Did Baylor lose this weekend?
No, sir. We play, the girls play the Longhorns tonight at 8.
Okay.
we're going for our fifth straight turn change. They took us to only 2 points last time, so it should be a good game. On September 23rd, 2013, Resolution 2013-55 authorized the fire department to apply for a FEMA grant for exhaust removal systems, and with an anticipated cash match of approximately $10,000, is a 10% match. Received the bid specifications from Chief Reed on January 22nd of this year. We advertised for bids on February 8th and 15th. Had a mandatory pre-bid meeting on February the 10th. Bids were opened at 1:30 Wednesday, February 17th, with two responsive bidders. These systems are very similar. Basically, they put a magnetic ring on the tailpipe, and then there's a hose that comes down and the magnets match, and there's an exhaust system. It's a flexible hose type system. It's an exhaust system. The systems are pretty similar except for the attachment devices. And while the apparent low bidder appears to be the magnet grip system from Clean Air Concepts, we're recommending the Plymovent system because of its attachment. It's a lot easier to attach. It's basically got like an L shape or a boot shape with a handle on it, and the firefighter can just walk up and it'll magnetically connect. The magnet grip system has like three pins that you have to align, so you actually have to get down on it and rotate it until you get it in the spot, and then it'll magnetically attach. So we're recommending the Plymovent system from Air Cleaning Technologies. Felix Camarillo did talk with the exhaust removal, the AFG grant people, and the grant, in his email to me, it says the grant office said that awarding the bid is up to the city. So we'd like to use it at our best value and award it to Plymouth for a total of $80,770.
Any questions?
I make a motion that we accept staff recommendation.
Second. Motion made by Commissioner Luber to accept staff's recommendation and award a bid appropriately, seconded by Commissioner Pena. Any other discussion? Roll call vote.
Commissioner Pena?
Yes.
Commissioner Luber?
Yes.
Mayor Pena?
Yes. Next item is an introduction item of an ordinance amending the fiscal year 2014-2015. General fund budget to provide matching funds for FEMA assistance for the firefighter grant for fire department vehicle exhaust removal system. This is just a right housekeeping measure to pay for all this stuff. It's an introduction item. So if anybody has any questions about it, just get a hold of the city manager. I'm sure she can answer your questions. With that, that's all the business we have sitting tonight. We're adjourned.